Hey everyone, this is Nick, and I wanted to show you how you can create a fun animated GIF in PowerPoint. You can make this as a GIF or as a video, and this little GIF right here, this sort of subscribe link or the subscribe animation, I created all in PowerPoint, and I'm going to show you all the steps that I used to make it here as well. And of course, I would be remiss if I didn't say I hope that you will subscribe to my channel for data design, Excel, and PowerPoint tutorial tips, and make sure to tap that bell there on the right. You'll get notified every single time I post a new video in any of those topics. So I'm going to go ahead and close out of this screen. And you can see that this is just the GIF file that I created in PowerPoint, and I put it on a slide. And so what we're going to do is go to a blank slide, and I'm going to show you all the different steps that we need to do to make this GIF. So the first thing is we're going to create all of our assets, all the different elements that are involved in that GIF. So first, I'm going to go ahead and insert a box, just a rectangle. And we're going to make this the subscribe button. So I'm going to say subscribe here. This is just like a Word doc. You can update the text, make it really big, maybe one size smaller there. I'm gonna go ahead and update the color on the shape format menu. We're gonna turn that red, say no outline. And then I'm going to duplicate this, push Control D to duplicate. And this is gonna be our subscribed button. So I'm gonna make that there and then update the colors to this gray, make it a lighter gray there. I'm going to bring this subscribe button to the front. So I'm going to right click, bring to front. I'm going to drag that right over that. And we're going to put these both kind of right here in the middle. Now I need to insert the bell icon. So to do that, I'm going to go to the insert tab on the menu, on the ribbon. We're going to go to the icon button there. And I'm going to go ahead and just search for bell. And we'll see what options I get. I like this one over here. So I'm going to go ahead and insert that bell. Let's make it just a little bit bigger. Maybe a little bigger than this. Just hold the shift key and then click on that arrow to proportionally increase the size. Then you won't stretch it vertically or horizontally. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm going to make this gray, that gray color again, and I'm gonna duplicate this and I'm gonna make this white, a white fill. And then I'm gonna make a border line here and that same gray color. Perfect, and we're gonna add that right on top. Okay, this is looking good. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make sure that these are aligned to the middle, and they were, so I'm gonna drag them to the middle there. And now we need to insert the cursor icon. So I'm gonna go back to the insert menu, go to the icon menu, and I'm just gonna type in cursor, that little arrow for my mouse. And actually, let's just actually type in cursor. I think that works perfectly. All right, we'll take that, we'll insert that. And I'm just going to adjust the size just a little bit to make it a little bit bigger. All right, so we have our base. And so what I want the animation to do, I'm gonna apply some animation to each of these objects. And what I want it to do is I want it automatically, I want the cursor to drag, to hover over the subscribe button. I want the subscribe, the red subscribe button to disappear to reveal the gray subscribed button on the back. And then I want the cursor to move again over to the bell. And that is going to hit the bell, and it's going to make this white bell disappear. We're going to add a teeter effect to kind of give it that little jittering animation motion. And then I want the cursor to go back to its starting point. And so we're just, and then we want that to just continue to repeat. And that's what it's going to do once we insert the GIF file. All right, so the first step we need to do here on our animated GIF is apply the initial motion path for the cursor. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna click on that icon, we're gonna go up to the animation tab on the ribbon, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna click this arrow and go all the way down. When you do that, you can see all the different options that you have for entrance, exit, and effect animations, and then you have this line of motion path. So you have the line, the arc, the turns. I'm gonna go ahead and just click on line. We just need a simple straight line. So when you do that, it automatically applies this vertical line here. I'm gonna go up to the effect options button and select right, because we want it to go from left to right. So now it's gonna move in that direction. Now when I have this motion path set, you can see we have the green arrow to start, the red arrow to stop. If I click this, we can, if I highlight the animation here, we can actually take this and drag it anywhere we want. So we can actually increase the size of that motion path. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. And also what I'm going to do on that animation, with this animation selected, you get the animation timing tabs up here in the menus. I'm going to go ahead and say with previous. That's going to make it so that I don't have to click to start the animation. It's just going to start on its own. Okay, so once this cursor gets to this point in the subscribe button, I want the red button to disappear and I want the gray button to appear. That's going to give it that subscribed effect. So now I'm going to go ahead and click on the subscribe button there and go up here to the different animations that I have. We're going to go down to the red section. That's the exit animations. And I'm going to go ahead and click on disappear. And when I do that, I'm going to go ahead to the timing. Instead of on click, I'm going to say after previous, because I want this to happen after the previous cursor animation happens. Now let's go ahead and click on preview and see what that looks like. Perfect. That's awesome. So now we're going to keep on going with some of the other additional elements of this animation. So now that we have the cursor going from here to the subscribe button disappears to reveal the subscribed, the gray subscribe button. Then I want the cursor to move another straight line over to the bell. So for this, if you want to add animation to an object that already has animation to it, you have to click that object and then go up to the advanced animation menu here, click on add animation. And I'm going to go back down to the motion paths right here. I'm going to select that line again. You can see it automatically applies that vertical line. We want to go ahead and make it horizontal, but all I need to do in this case is take the end here, this red, go all the way to the bell, and then I'm going to take the start button and bring that all the way to where my last motion path ended. And what I'm going to do here is I'm going to go ahead and click on, instead of on click on the timing menu, we're going to say after previous, because we want this to happen after that subscribe button turns to gray. So let's go ahead and preview this to see what it will look like. Click on the preview button there in the left, and it keeps on going. Perfect. All right, so we're making the steps here. We're getting pretty good here. So now once this cursor makes its way over to the bell, I want the white bell to disappear. So we're going to go ahead and click on the red section here for the exit animation. We're going to click on disappear. And again, I'm going to go ahead and say, instead of on click, we're going to say after previous. Let's go ahead and click on preview again. Subscribed. Boom. All right. So now once that happens, I want that gray bell to do this little teetering effect. So what we need to do here is I need to get to that bell behind. I'm going to go ahead and click on the bell, the gray bell that's behind the white bell. And over here, up here in the menu, the yellow section, these are the effect animations. So these are different things. They're not going to make an object appear or exit. It's just going to add a specific effect to it. And all I need to do with that is go over to this little teeter effect here. So we'll go ahead and click on that. And then what I'm going to do here is we're going to apply, instead of on click, this time we're going to say with previous. So it will teeter at the same time that the white bell disappears. So now what we can do is move that white bell back into position. All right. And then I need to, let's go ahead and preview it to see what it looks like so far. It's going to click on subscribed. The bell disappears and teeters. Perfect. And now the very final part of the animation, we want the cursor to move from the bell back to its starting position. So I'm going to go ahead and click on the cursor again. We're going to add animation from the animation menu there. We're going to go back to motion paths. And now we get that default vertical. What I'm going to do now is we're going to move the start position all the way over to the bell, and the end position, we're going to end back where it started. So this should work, and I'm going to go ahead again on click. We're going to say after previous. Now let's go ahead and preview and see what it looks like. Click on preview there. Subscribed. The bell disappears and teeters. And now we move back. Now there's a little bit of a lag there on that last animation. If you need to update any animations, what you can do is click on the animation pane here, and this basically gives you a list of all the different animations that you have, and it gives you the timings. So what I'm going to do here is I wanted this to happen a little quicker, and I'm going to change this to see what would happen. So on the final motion path, that's the one that goes from the right to the left, we have it set to after previous. But if I click on with previous, you can see this blue part, this timing line, is going to move so that it's in alignment with the previous animation there. So let's go ahead and say with previous and see what happens. Okay, so I'm going to do this, and then I think this might work. I'm going to go ahead and click preview again to see what it looks like. Moves to subscribe, click the bell and teeter, and then goes right back. So that gives it more of a smooth effect to say with previous animation instead of after previous animation. So now if I were to play this in slideshow mode, it will automatically perform that animated motion there. Very, very cool. Okay, now I'm going to escape out of here. Now comes the fun part. You can export this to a video or to a GIF. And if you export it to a GIF, then you're going to get that repeating motion. So what we want to do is go up to the File tab here. Actually, I already have this slide right here, so I'm actually going to delete this slide. We don't need it anymore. I just want this slide, and this is my my GIF slide here. So what we're going to do is go up to File, and then what you're going to do is go down to this Export tab right here. Once you click on Export, you're going to get a bunch of options. You can export it to a PDF, you can create a video, or you can create an animated GIF right here, and I'm going to click on that. You don't need to worry about any of these timings. It's actually just going to use the timings that we have in the slide. But if you wanted to set some custom, if you had multiple slides here and you wanted to set some custom timings, this is where you could do it. You could increase that, the seconds per slide there. And then one thing that I really like to do is make sure to check this box that says make the background transparent. If I don't select this box, it's going to export a GIF with a total white background, and it's going to be the size of the slide, and that might be okay. But if I say make the background transparent, then that's actually going to allow us to put the GIF over any other color background, and you won't have that white that appears. So we're going to go ahead and select the make background transparent. I'm going to go ahead and say create GIF. It takes just a little bit of time. We're going to go ahead and just tell it where we want it to save. And I'm just going to say subscribe GIF. I've already done this a bunch of times, so I have a bunch on my desktop already. So I'm just going to say V2 there. I'm going to say save. It just takes a little bit of time to export. And then if you wanted to, let's say, insert it on another slide. You could also add it to any of your social media accounts. I'm going to go ahead and insert, just like I would insert an image. So go to the picture file here from this device. And I think we've had enough time. So I'm going to go ahead and down here, right here, subscribe GIF V2, insert. And you can see it's a beautiful GIF that repeats over and over and over. So cool. And again, if you were to play this in slideshow mode and just have one big slide, it would automatically run for you there. Now you can see that the resolution is just a little bit grainy, so you probably have to play with that, make this a little bit smaller, and that's just totally okay. I think if you were to post this on social media, most of the GIFs that we see are on Twitter or something like that, Facebook, and you know, it'll look perfect. It'll be a perfect size for sort of that medium. So if you like this video, I hope you will give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button on my channel and tap the bell next to it to get updates every time I post a new tutorial on data design, Excel, or PowerPoint. Remember, you don't need to be a professional designer to look like one using the software that you use and have access to every single day. I hope you have a great day. I had a great time making this video for you, and I will see you next time.